Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video series, we want to take a look behind the scenes of the Extending SAP Solutions Using Microsoft Power Platform webinar. This is chapter 6, where we want to post an adaptive cards to teams from our Power Automate flow. The last step that is missing from our automatic product creation using Power Automate is the approval step from within Microsoft Teams. So basically, we have done most of the flows, most of the steps of this specific flow already. We are listening to the trigger in Outlook. We are processing the incoming PDF documents, and we are actually creating the products in the SAP system. Now, what we want to do is we want to add two more steps. One step that posts an adaptive card to a Teams user, where the user then gets a notification of, look, this is the product information, or this is the product that would be created in the SAP system. We'll then wait and ask for the decision that the user makes. And if the user approves the step, then we would create the product in the SAP systems. Otherwise, we'll just go ahead and do nothing. So in order to do this, we're actually using something called adaptive card. And adaptive cards are platform agnostic snippets of a user interface that you can easily embed in Teams, in Outlook, and in lots of other specific applications. The only thing that you need to do there is post a certain JSON payload, and this payload is then rendered in a beautiful way within the application itself. The great thing there is that you not only can post some content and display some information, but you can actually also ask the user for certain actions. In our case, these actions will be an approval or rejection flow to actually post or reject the product in the SAP system. Okay, now that our Power Automate flow is able to react to the incoming email, is able to process the PDF document and to create the actual products in the SAP system, it's time to add an approval step. So we want this approval to happen in Teams. So that's why we add here an additional action, look for Teams, and we'll select the action to actually send an adaptive card, post an adaptive card, a Teams user, and wait for the response there. So that will be the action that allows us to make this approval step. I have already connected this to my user, so that's all fine. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to identify who is the user who should actually see this adaptive card. So I'll end the Johnny user here, and we'll switch over to creating the adaptive card that we actually want to show to the user. So here in this adaptive card designer, you can easily drag and drop and create your very own adaptive card, which is basically the foundation of what will be used or displayed in Teams or in Outlook or whatever. And this designer actually helps you really build the skeleton to then show it in your application. In my specific case here, I have already an adaptive card created. Be sure to use the target version 1.2 because there are some restrictions there. And my very simple adaptive card has these properties, product ID, name, price, and two actions, approve and reject. So the product ID here is there. And obviously we need to update this later on in our Power Automate flow, but here's everything that we need to know. So I'll copy and paste the content of this adaptive card here into my message. And as mentioned before, now I need to replace these hard-coded values, the product ID, with the content that we actually extracted from our PDF document. So here down here in this dynamic table, I'll just select the product ID. Now the same thing here again for the data. We'll do the same for the product name. So again, I just take from the previous step, from the table one product name, I'll select this one, the same for the price, table one price value, and also for the data. And that's basically it. Obviously, this could be more sophisticated. I could also link the PDF document or something like that. But here, I'm just fine. Then I'll add this update message. So once the user makes a decision, I want to just reply with thanks for your decision, and that's it. Now we can save this flow and give it a try. So we'll switch over to Outlook, where we'll again send an email to our user, to Johnny. We'll put the attachment from before into this email and send this, which basically triggers our Power Automate flow. So if we head over to Power Automate, if we look at the history runs, then we can see, okay, our Power Automate flow is actually currently running. So that's perfect. And we can see it's in this step. And you can see right now that there's an adaptive card that just appeared. So let's switch over to Teams. And here you can see the adaptive card that we have. So add a new product. We see our Surface 1, the price. And we can click on approve or reject for this specific card. We also see our reply here. Thanks for your decision. Now we continue with the next product. So we can really see how the Power Automate flow now loops over all the products that are in this table. So we approved two of them and we rejected one of the properties. And that's very interesting because now if we look at the result or what actually happened here with our adaptive card, we can see here this is the first one which we approved. So there's this submit action ID approve. If we actually switch to the next one which we had declined, which we had rejected, then here you can see submit action ID rejected. And obviously that's something that we can now use to make our Power Automate flow really conditional. So we will check what the answer of this specific Power Automate flow or this specific action was. So we'll add here an operation from control, and there's a condition control, which now allows us to make an if statement. And so what we'll do here is we'll add some expression that allows us to check this submitted action ID property that we had seen before. So here in expression, I'll just add from this post an adaptive card. So from this body, body, post an adaptive card. So that was the previous step. And we want to get the answer for the specific property submit action ID. Remember, that was the one thing where we had approve and reject. So I'll just add this as at the condition and say, well, if this is approved, so if the answer to this was approved, then we'll go into the yes flow and I'll just drag and drop the actions that we want to have there from below into the yes flow. So get product and add product, both of them should only be executed if the condition is true. So if our submit action ID was approved. If it's not, if it's rejected, then we'll don't do anything. I mean, this could be an additional flow. This could be some additional workflows that are started. But for now, it's perfectly fine. So let's repeat what we did. We'll just again send an email. So over in Outlook here, we'll create a new message. We'll send it again to Johnny. We'll add the content from our email. Or actually, we will add a new PDF document because we need to make sure that the product are not yet available in the SAP system. So now we'll have this HBL 1000. Remember, before we had HBK or something like that. Now we have HBL as the unique product ID in the SAP system. We send the email, and now we can just wait for our notification in Teams. So the Power Automate flow is now triggered, hopefully. The PDF document is extracted, and here we go. Here we see the first flow, HBL 1000. We can approve this one. Then we should get the second product, HBL 1001, which we'll reject. So we don't want this one to appear in our SAP system. And actually, the third one will approve reject as well. So now if we head over to our flow, we should exactly see these steps here outlined, obviously, as well. So of course the whole process begins. We'll extract everything, and now we have these conditions. So we can see the first one for the first item is actually true. The second one is false. So here you can see the get product and add product are both disabled or did not happen. And the third one, it's the same situation. So both of them also were not executed. Which now means if we switch over to the Fiori Launchpad, to our Fiori screen, and take a look at the products, and actually search for this HBL product, we should see one product And that's exactly our Surface 1 that was automatically created.